Welcome to our section on how to administer Microsoft Fabric. Administering Microsoft Fabric involves a range of tasks that are essential for ensuring that efficient and effective use of Fabric platform within your organization. As a Fabric administrator, you need to have a solid understanding of the Fabric architecture, security and governance features, analytical capabilities, and various deployment and licensing. You also need to be familiar with the Fabric Admin Portal and other administrative tools like the Admin Center, how to manage user access, and how to be able to configure and manage the Fabric environment to meet the needs of your organization. As we learned in the Fabric introduction, Microsoft Fabric is an all-in-one analytics solution for enterprises that covers everything from data movement to data science to real-time intelligence and business intelligence. It offers a comprehensive suite of services, including data lake, data engineering, data integration, all in one place. And with Fabric, you don't need to piece together different services from multiple vendors. Instead, you can enjoy a highly integrated end-to-end and easy-to-use product that is designed to simplify your analytic needs. Microsoft Fabric is built on the foundation of Software as a Service, or SaaS, which takes simplicity and integration to a whole new level. It brings together new and existing components from Power BI, Azure Synapse, and Azure Data Factory into a single integrated environment. These components are then presented in various customized user experiences tailored to different roles and tasks. Microsoft Fabric allows you to unify your data estate, manage powerful AI models, empower everyone in your business, and govern data across your organization. It also enables you to innovate faster with helping every person in your organization act on insights from within Microsoft 365 apps such as Excel and more. The image here shows the Fabric components with one lake as the foundation, with each experience listed on top. All of the Fabric experiences use OneLake as their native store without needing any additional configuration. OneLake is hierarchical in nature to simplify management across your organization. There's only one OneLake per tenant, and it provides a single pane of glass for your file system namespace that spans across users, regions, and even clouds. The data in OneLake is also divided into manageable containers for easy handling. If we actually look at how this data is stored in OneLake, you're not going to see data items in workspaces. You will see files and folders, just like you would in a data lake today. All workspaces are folders. Each data item will be a file. Any tabular data is stored in a Delta Lake format. There are no new proprietary file formats for Fabric because proprietary formats create data silos. Even the warehouse natively stores all data in a Delta Lake format, while Fabric data items will standardize on Delta for tabular data. OneLake is still a data lake built on top of the ADLS Gen 2 or Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2. It will support any file type, structured or unstructured. Data in your OneLake is automatically indexed for discovery and includes Microsoft Information Protection labels, lineage, personal information identifier scans, sharing, governance, and compliance. A Fabric tenant is a dedicated space for organizations to create, store, and manage Fabric items. There's often a single instance of Fabric for an organization, and it's aligned with Microsoft Enter ID, formerly known as Active Directory. The Fabric tenant maps to the root of OneLake and is at the top level of the hierarchy. Capacity is a dedicated set of resources that are available at any given time to be used. A tenant can have one or more capacities associated with it. Capacities define the ability of a resource to perform an activity or produce output. Different items consume different capacity at different times. Fabric offers capacity through Fabric SKUs and trials. A domain is a logical grouping of workspaces. Domains are used to organize items in a way that makes sense for your organization. You can group things together in a way that make it easier for the right people to have access to the right workspaces. For example, you might have a domain for sales, another for marketing, another for finance. A workspace is a collection of items that brings together different functionality in a single tenant. It acts as a container that leverages capacity for work that is executed and provides controls for who can access the items in it. For example, in a sales workspace, users associated with the sales organization can create a data warehouse, notebooks, they can create data sets, create reports. Fabric items are the building blocks of the Fabric platform. They're the objects that you create and manage in Fabric. There are different types of items, such as a data warehouse, data pipelines, data sets, reports, dashboards, and understanding Fabric concepts is important for you as an admin because it helps you understand how to manage the Fabric environment. As an administrator, you may be responsible for a wide range of tasks to keep the Fabric platform running smoothly. One of the most important aspects of Fabric administration is managing security and access control to ensure that only authorized users can access sensitive data. And you can use role-based access control, or RBAC, to define who can view and edit content, set up data gateways to securely connect to on-prem data sources, and use Microsoft Enter ID to manage user access. Effective Fabric administration requires a solid understanding of data governance principles. You should know how to secure inbound and outbound connectivity in your tenant and how to monitor usage and performance metrics. You should also know how to apply data governance policies to ensure data within your tenant is only accessible to authorized users. Fabric administration also involves customizing and configuring the platform to meet the needs of your organization. This can include configuring private links to secure your tenant, defining data classification policies, and adjusting the look and feel of reports and dashboards. As a Fabric admin, you need to know how to monitor the performance and usage of the platform, how to optimize resources, and how to troubleshoot issues. This includes configuring monitoring and alert settings, optimizing query performance, managing capacity and scaling, and troubleshooting data refresh and connectivity issues. Specific tasks may vary depending on the needs of your organization and the complexity of your Fabric implementation. You need to familiarize yourself with a few tools to effectively implement the tasks outlined previously. Fabric admins can perform most admin tasks using one of the following tools: the Fabric Admin Portal, PowerShell Commandlets, Admin APIs and SDKs, the Admin Monitoring Workspace, and the Fabric Capacity Metrics app. You may not need to use all of these tools, and in fact, you may not have access to some of them. We're going to cover a few of these tools going forward, as you're likely to use them to administer Microsoft Fabric. You should be aware of these tools, how to use them, and what they do. Microsoft Fabric Admin Portal is a web-based portal where you can manage all aspects of the platform. In the admin portal, you can centrally manage, review, and apply settings for the entire tenant or by capacity. You can also manage users, admins, groups, access, audit logs, and monitor usage and performance. It's important to familiarize yourself with the features that can be controlled in the admin portal, even if you're not an admin, so you know exactly what it can do. For example, you need to be able to publish a Power BI report to the web or write a semantic model using the XML endpoint. Access to the admin portal requires a Fabric license, and the portal is accessible to admins with roles such as Global Administrator, Power Platform Administrator, and Fabric Administrator. There's one setting that I'd like to call out, which may change how you and your users experience Fabric. The Fabric on and off switch shown here on the right is located in tenant settings and lets organizations use Power BI opt into Fabric if they'd like. Here you can enable Fabric from your tenant and or allow capacity admins to manage Fabric. Fabric tenant admins have access to the new admin monitoring workspace. You can choose to share access to the admin monitoring workspace or specific items within it with other users in your organization. The admin monitoring workspace includes the feature use and adoption data set and report, which together provides insights on the usage and performance of your Fabric environment. You can use this information to identify trends, patterns, and to troubleshoot issues. Understanding the admin monitoring workspace equips you with essential tools for effective administration, security, governance, all within our Fabric environment. You must be a capacity admin to install and view the Microsoft Fabric Capacity Metrics app. This may be an opportunity for you to work with your admin, if it's not you, to understand what's going on in your Fabric tenant. The Microsoft Fabric Capacity Metrics app is designed to provide monitoring capabilities for Microsoft Fabric capacities. Monitoring your capacities is essential for making informed decisions on how to best use your capacity resources. For example, the app may help you identify when to scale up your capacity or when to turn on auto-scale. The app shows how much compute is used by each workload type and helps administrators identify inefficiencies in capacity usage. Note that Microsoft Fabric security is based on Power BI security. Your role as an admin is to manage security for the Fabric environment, including managing users and groups and managing how users interact with Fabric in terms of sharing and distributing content. Let's talk briefly about some of the security features available in Microsoft Fabric. Conditional access allows you to secure your apps using Microsoft Enter ID to only allow users to connect from certain allowed IP addresses, locations, group membership, apps, and more. Resiliency offers reliability and regional resiliency with Azure availability zones. Lockboxes control how Fabric and Microsoft engineers can access data. Service tags enable an Azure SQL managed instance to allow incoming connections from Microsoft Fabric. And OneLake security allows you to secure your data in OneLake. Notice the layers of security that help protect your data, from network security to workspace to item access controls to data security access controls, all talked about in previous security sections. Notice too the secured inbound and outbound connectivity provided with data encryption and end-to-end auditability with Microsoft Purview built in to help manage, govern, and to help ensure your data estate is compliant, and not to mention high availability and disaster recovery are built right in. Licenses control the level of access and functionality that users have within the Fabric environment. Administrators can ensure that licensed users have the necessary access to data and analytics to perform their roles effectively, while also limiting access to sensitive data and ensuring compliance with data protection laws and regulations. Managing licenses allows administrators to monitor and control costs by ensuring that licenses are allocated efficiently and only to users who need them. This can help to prevent unnecessary expenses and ensure that the organization is utilizing its resources effectively, having the appropriate procedures in place to assign and manage licenses helps to control access to data and analytics and ensures compliance with regulations and optimizes costs. License management for Fabric is handled in Microsoft 365, the Admin Center, as shown here on the right. Fabric has a few built-in governance features to help you manage and control your data. Endorsement is a way for you as an admin to designate specific Fabric items as trusted and approved for use across your organization. Admins can also make use of the Scanner API to scan Fabric items for sensitive data, and the Data Lineage feature to track the flow of data through Fabric. Content endorsement is an essential governance feature that helps you establish trust in your data assets by promoting and certifying specific Fabric items as trusted and approved for use across your entire organization. All Fabric items can be endorsed except dashboards. Promoted Fabric content appears with a promoted badge in the Fabric portal, as seen here on the right. Workspace members with the contributor or admin role can promote content within a workspace, while the Fabric admin can promote content across the organization. Endorsed assets are identified with a badge that indicates that they have been reviewed and approved. Endorsement helps your users know which assets they can trust and rely on for accurate information. And it also helps you as an admin manage the overall growth of items across your environment. Content certification is a more formal process that involves a review of the content by a designated reviewer. Certified Fabric content appears with a certified badge in the Fabric portal. The certification process is managed by you, the admin, and can be customized to meet the needs of your organization. If you aren't an admin, you need to request item certification from an admin. You can request certification by selecting the item in the Fabric portal and then selecting Request Certification from the More menu. Data lineage is the ability to track the flow of data through Fabric. Data lineage allows you to see where data comes from, how it's transformed, where it goes. This helps you understand the data that is available in Fabric and how it's being used. Metadata scanning facilitates governance for data by enabling cataloging and reporting of all metadata in your organization's Fabric items. The Scanner API is a set of admin REST APIs that allow you to scan Fabric items for sensitive data. Use the Scanner API to scan data warehouses, data pipelines, data sets, reports, and dashboards for sensitive data. The Scanner API can be used to both scan structured and unstructured data. Before metadata scanning can be run, it needs to be set up in your organization by your admin. Now it's time for our knowledge check. Question one, which of the following statements best describes the concept of capacity in Fabric? Answer, capacity defines the ability of a resource to perform an activity or produce output. Question two, which of the following statements is true about the difference between promotion and certification in Fabric? Answer, certification must be enabled in the tenant by the admin, while promotion can be done by a workspace member. In this section, we talked about Microsoft Fabric architecture and critical concepts like tenant, capacity, domain, workspace, and items. We also discussed typical Fabric admin tasks and tools that you might want to use, like the Fabric admin portal for monitoring workspaces and capacity metrics app. We then looked at the layers of the Microsoft Fabric security and how to assign and manage user licenses and govern data in Fabric. For more information on how to administer Microsoft Fabric, please see the link shown here. Thank you so much for tuning in to the DP-700 course. Remember, there are many ways to continue your learning journey. We encourage you to search out your next favorite topic on Microsoft Learn at aka.ms/learn. See you next time.